everyone. I, Megha Ahuja, welcome you all to Sashakt Dialogues, an attempt by Sashakt, the Ovarian Cancer Foundation, to break the silence and start meaningful conversations to combat unjustified cancer-related stigmas. So, for this special episode in which we are going to discuss about gossip and verbal abuse, we have two beautiful and inspiring guests with us today. Achal Sharma, founder Meals of Happiness and a cancer crusader, and Ruchi Jain, director Pink Talk Pinkish Foundation. Hi Achal, hi Ruchi. Welcome to the show.
Hi Megha, hi Achal. It's a privilege to be here, absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Yes, it's a privilege, I would say. I'm the same thing because Megha always come up with something beautiful on the other side. You know, so thank you so much for giving me once again this opportunity.
I'm so glad to have you on board. Receiving a diagnosis of cancer is terrible. Every person deserves to live in an environment that is both physically and emotionally safe. However, for some patients with cancer, that is not the case. For the person who has been diagnosed with cancer, it can be terrible when the people around them, instead of supporting them, spread rumors about them or verbally abuse them. Starting with you, Achal, how do you think rumors and gossip can take toll on the already suffering cancer patient? Did you have to face it?
I faced Megha. Reason being, I'll tell you, it's upon me or whosoever is going through. Lots of people used to criticize me in a different way, like somebody's asking me how Anchal you are coping up with chemo, and there is some other third person is standing next to us. So I reply him, I was like, it's normal and there are little difficulties, but I'm coping up well, right? But the third person says immediately, because he know me well and he used to be a good friend, he said, Anchal, you know, what is this drama? What chemo? What is this chemo is going on, you know? And I was shocked. And then the guy who asked me, he replied, I was like, boss, why don't you go and take one chemo session? Then you realize what I'm talking to her. So is tarike ke jo the tolerance rehti hai wo is time pe, they don't realize that what they are talking, the person who's already going through so much of changes in body and so much of suffering and pain, on top of that you comment like this, it can actually add on, right? So I had couple of events like this, Megha, where one more event I will share here. I was sitting and having a coffee in my gym, because I never miss my gym during my treatment also. So I was having a coffee, and I don't have a habit to wear a scarf. So I was like without hair, wearing my gym clothes and going gym every day. I was sitting there and somebody again asked me, and how you are doing, Achal? How's the cancer thing is going on? I was like, okay, it's about to finish now. And I was giving her a positive and a strong side of me, but the person is only focusing on, Achal, everything is okay, but I recently lost one of my cousins, same case, same age. So yes, it is actually take a huge toll on someone who's going through this disease.
Definitely, it's the hope that everybody needs. Like, when yes, we have to be very, very sensitive when we're talking to a cancer patient, because the only thing they need is love and care. Pity or anything else is not what they require.
Yeah.
Coming to you, Ruchi, emotional and verbal abuse can take many forms and can come from partners, caregivers, co-workers, parents, and others. Though there's a thin line that separates general arguments from verbal abuse, how can someone get to know that they're being verbally abused and how should they deal with it?
Thank you, Megha and Achal. I totally agree with you, what you have just said, And yes, I totally agree with you as well, Megha. Verbal abuse comes in many forms. And, it is very, very important for us to understand that when general arguments turn into the verbal abuse, you never know. You know that arguments are not always bad. But at the meanwhile, if they help you see the clear picture of things, and if you should indulge in an argument only till the extent when you think that yours and the other person's notion are logical and it actually makes sense. You have to understand that when the other person starts converting the argument into personal attack, ये समझना बहुत जरूरी है कि जब आपको ये लगना स्टार्ट हो जाए कि सामने वाला आपको पर्सनल अटैक कर, सो दिस इज द मोमेंट you will have to either stand up for yourself or shut the person out completely. I think that is very important, because being a victim of verbal abuse is as wrong as it doing it. कहते हैं ना कि अगर आप किसी का जो दुख है वो बांट नहीं सकते तो एटलीस्ट बढ़ाइए तुम्हारा. सो वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस फाइन लाइन बिटवीन जनरल आर्गुमेंट एंड वर्बल अब्यूज, यू रियली नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज रॉन्ग एंड राइट इन दैट आर्गुमेंट.
आई वांट टू ऐड ऑन हियर मेगा, यू नो व्हाट एवरीवन, आई वाज सो डिटरमिन्ड टुवर्ड्स माय रिकवरी एंड पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड दैट डजंट, दैट कमेंट लाइक दिस डजंट इफेक्ट मी, बट एवरीवन डोंट टेक इट दैट स्ट्रांगली एंड पॉजिटिवली. सो वन शुड ऑलवेज कीप इन माइंड whom you are talking, what you are talking, and is that give them stress or increase their pain. But people are here, we don't need to listen when going through a cancer about cancer. There are a lot more things you can talk about, right? So yes, that's the only thing I want to say about this.
That's so very true, and it's very important to normalize cancer, because if somebody has diabetes, we don't keep on telling them that you have diabetes. But we do the same thing with the cancer patients. Every time, everybody is talking to them only about their diagnosis. However, they're doing n number of things. Like Achal is an inspiration. She's been doing so many things, and so are so many other survivors and patients. They have their own individuality, and that needs to be respected. And verbal abuse is something that is not at all accepted. And especially at the time when they need love, support, and care, at that time, if the person is not sensitive enough, I think it's not done. So what may be surprising how difficult it can be to tell rumor and gossip from truth. People can have trouble telling what's real and what's not. In case of cancer patients, rumors can range from made up reasons for their diagnosis to they're being cursed, to seeing them as unlucky or whatnot. Achal, how should one deal with it?
See, lots of people told me, my first thing, my lots of close friends who used to party with me, and you know, they are, few of them are like my extended family, they left me when I needed them the most. And by saying this, this is your karma, and maybe someone curse you, or if somebody is, you know, if we, I'll tell you a real example. A friend of mine whom I supported day and night, I was with them whenever they need any medical support in the hospital, two to three days with them, because their kids are out of India, right? The person whom I'm expecting next to me immediately when I was diagnosed with this, person blocked me completely, leave me in the middle, and she was saying that, you know, it's a curse and I don't want to be around, it might affect me. So these kind of mentality is still exist, and trust me, people, I don't know why they don't think what they are talking, it can actually damage that person more than the cancer. Cancer can is still curable, and it cured. I am also an example in front of you, right? I lived my best life during the cancer treatment, modeling, other activities, lots of other event I have done, right? But people like them still need to understand cancer is just a disease. It will be, you know, cured. Nowadays, there are so many treatments are there, and there are lots of, you know, winners story. Mega, you know so many winners already, right? But we don't want to give them example of winners. We don't want to give them example who fought for the extreme stage or last stage of cancer. We always give example with the sympathy. Oh ho, uske saath to ye ho gaya. Oh ho, uske saath to ye ho gaya. Ab to, that's the reason cancer patients don't live their life post cancer treatment also happily and normally. Life change completely. Every pain, every discomfort, person start relating to the cancer. You know, it might come back. It might recurring. We all need to understand ki bhaiya, cancer is a disease only. So please stop giving us that kind of sympathy, we don't need it at all.
So Achal, aapki is baat pe yahan pe main ye bolungi, actually cancer disease nahi hai, unka jo dimag mein jo mindset hai wo ek sabse badi disease hai. I think jis din wo disease theek ho gayi na, to shayad puri duniya ke andar jo ek stigma bana rakha hai cancer ko leke ki wo disease hai, shayad wo usi din hum sab kamyab ho jayenge.
Very true, kyunki whenever it happens to anyone, half the battle is lost when hope is lost. And by all such things happening around them, the patients end up losing their hope. Because when they hear again and again stories of people who have lost to the disease, the only thing they believe is that cancer is a death sentence and they're going to die soon. And once the patient gets into that mindset, it's very, very difficult for them to cope with the treatment. And a big salute to you, Archil, for the, like, despite all the things happening around you, the way you fought it so bravely, and you're truly an inspiration. So, Ruchi, most of the times people just talk without thinking what impact it can have on others. From telling the patient that you're dying soon to asking questions about what did they do to get cancer, it all happens. Do you think we need to be more sensitive as a society, specifically while dealing with subjects like cancer? How can we take a step towards that?
Absolutely. And you know what, like, yes, definitely we should. It is so very inhuman, you know, for all of us when we are being insensitive towards someone who's already fighting a battle between life and death. और कहते हैं ना, हम मरने से पहले ही अपनी बातों से उस इंसान को पहले ही मार देते हैं। वो इंसान जब वो लास्ट स्टेज आएगी तब तो आएगी ही, बट आई थिंक उससे पहले ही हम उसे खत्म कर देते हैं, निस्तानाबूद कर देते हैं अपनी बातों से। वो एक बार जो मुंह का कमान, जो हमारी तीर जो निकल जाता है, आई थिंक वो आप उसको वापस नहीं कर सकते। वो जिंदगी भर का जख्म होता है। कैंसर इतना बड़ा जख्म नहीं है जितना वो आप जो बोलते हैं वो उतना बड़ा जख्म बन जाता है। एंड यू नो, वी कैन नॉट प्रिवेंट द अनफोर्सीन फ्यूचर, बट इफ समवन इज इन सच अ सिचुएशन, द लीस्ट वी कैन डू इज दैट बी कंपैशनेट टुवर्ड्स दैट पर्सन। यू नो, इट इज सो इंपॉर्टेंट। एंड यू नो व्हाट, लाइक दे डोंट वांट सिंपैथी। I don't understand that. How difficult is this to understand that they do not need sympathy from us? All they need is just love and compassion. That is it. And you know what, Archer, you just told that you lived your life the best in when you were going through with that phase. I think that is the biggest slap on those people faces who said ki aap ek bada curse hai unke liye. I always believe that, you know, whatever happens in life is always for good. So good, you know, that you got the true colors of that person.
It's very true. Like, we as a society need to be much more sensitive. We need to think before talking to anybody. Like, just saying things without thinking what impact it can have on the person who's hearing those things, it's something that is really, really wrong.
पर मेघा, एक और बात बताऊं आपको, शर्म भी आती है। 2021 में बैठे हैं हम लोग, पढ़े लिखे बोलते हैं, हम अपने आप को हाईली एजुकेटेड बोलते हैं, यू नो व्हाट नॉट वी आर डूइंग इन टुडेज वर्ल्ड, एंड स्टिल वी नीड टू टॉक ऑन दिस। दिस इज रियली शेमफुल समवेयर।
यस, बिकॉज़ ऑल दिस इज राइट नाउ हैपनिंग अराउंड अस। लाइक व्हाइल इवन व्हाइल वी आर टॉकिंग, देयर मस्ट बी सम पेशेंट्स हु मस्ट बी हियरिंग सो मेनी थिंग्स अराउंड देम।
There are lots of people told me one thing, Megha. Nowadays, I'm talking to lots of cancer patients from all over India, doing a counseling and giving them a brighter side of recovery. On the same time, few people I know, they, you know what they're talking about. This need to be changed, actually. Archal, why you are talking day and night to cancer patient? Your cancer may be come back. If someone helping someone, how that cancer will come back or relevant to that ki bhaiya unka cancer mein aap help kar rahe ho, unko ek aap strong side de rahe ho, wo cancer mera kaise wapas aa sakta hai? That means you are saying that all the doctors should stop performing surgeries because they day and night performing cancer surgeries. You know, hamara mind yahan pe itna backward hai abhi tak. We need to change this mindset.
Exactly. That is the whole reason behind sitting together and talking.
Because half of the cancer survivors still don't want to share their journey and still don't want to come forward to help other cancer fellow. That is also very bad.
Very true. Archal, family plays an important role in any cancer patient's journey. And it's the love and care of the family members that can help them sail through it. But if it's the member of the family only who are abusing the patients or cursing them for spoiling their life with their diagnosis, what should be done?
See, I don't have that experience because my family honestly very supported, being very, very supported throughout the treatment. First day when I told them that I was diagnosed with cancer, that is also because before जब तक मेरे follow-ups चल रहे थे I got to know, मैंने अपनी family में share भी नहीं किया था because मेरे brother की शादी चल रही थी उस time पे घर में, right? So it's very difficult to hold such a big news within you. And when I told them, मैंने अपना chemo pot लगाया था, first surgery I have done and drove back to home, and that day I told them that I was diagnosed with the cancer because that day the pipe and port was installed here, I can't hide that, right? So family start crying and you know all that drama start happening, you know, ye kya ho gaya, tu jhoot bol rahi hai aur aisa kaise ho sakta hai. I told them only one simple thing: if you act like this, I will leave this house because you people already decide that I am going to die, though I am not, right? I need your strong support, not your sympathy. And trust me, after that my family only forget that she's going through a cancer. They behave or act with me very, very normal, which is very much needed. Trust me, Megha, no cancer patient need extra care. We are capable enough to deal with our normal life. It just sometimes that extra care also indirectly give us message that, you know, something is wrong and something is going to happen with us soon or later, right? So we need to understand as a family, as a friends around us, that don't show them your sympathy or extra care. Just be genuine, be normal with them. That's all I know.
Exactly. I'm really glad that you got support of your family, but at times we've heard stories when even husbands leave their wives only because they've got cancer. Yes, and such things do happen.
I completely agree.
Even yeah. I have witnessed many cancer patients during my treatment time. They give divorce to their wife just because she recently got married and now she diagnosed with the cancer. Who will take care of all the expenses? Yes. And now it become a liability on him. So, first thing, hum logo ko bhi samajhna padega, Megha. It's not about society, not about the family. I believe whosoever is diagnosed at this stage after 30 or after 20, we are all capable enough to take care of ourselves financially. If not, still we have a lots of NGOs and organization around who can help us out, right? So Absolutely. Please, my only message, to don't give a shit who your family member, a person who's talking negative about you or thinking you are a curse. Please be within you. आपको अपने आप को फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू एक्सेप्ट योर ओन सेल्फ. लॉट्स ऑफ पीपल गिव अप जस्ट बिकॉज की फैमिली क्या सोच रही है, भाई क्या सोच रहा है, भाभी क्या सोच रही है. आई एम लाइबिलिटी ऑन देम. डोंट टेक दैट लाइबिलिटी. नो हु इज आस्किंग यू टू टेक दैट लाइबिलिटी. टेक केयर ऑफ योर ओन सेल्फ एंड यू कैन एंड एवरीवन कैन टेक केयर ऑफ देम सेल्फ. एंड पीपल गिव होप दैट यू नो दे डोंट गेट लव. उनकी शादी नहीं होगी कैंसर डायग्नोज होने के बाद. उनके बच्चों का क्या होगा? दे आर स्टिल थिंकिंग अबाउट देयर फ्यूचर हस्बैंड एंड फ्यूचर किड्स. Here I'm saying, my take is, please think about yourself. You become a selfish here. Agar aap hai, toh sab kuch hai. First, you take care of yourself. I am the one who, I think I cherish every moment of my, and trust me, I get love of my life during the cancer treatment, where wow. People are leaving their wives and husbands. My life partner proposed me at the time of second chemo, and I asked him, are you out of your mind? I don't know how long I will live. He said only one thing, you know, that is what? Maybe Achal, you know the time of dying and I don't know that date. Let's walk together. So it just, again, we need to believe within us. We need to believe in us. That's very important. So a person who can embrace their pain also, na, I don't think so. कोई भी उससे ज्यादा ब्यूटीफुल लग सकता है दैट टाइम.
नथिंग कैन डू दैट.
सो वेरी ट्रू. लाइक इट डिपेंड्स ऑन आवर एटीट्यूड. इट डिपेंड्स हाउ वी आर टेकिंग द होल जर्नी एंड एम्ब्रेसिंग आवरसेल्फ, एम्ब्रेसिंग द पेन. इट्स समथिंग दैट कैन टेक अस टू प्लेसेस डिस्पाइट आवर डायग्नोसिस, डिस्पाइट आवर कंडीशन. नो बैटल इज इम्पॉसिबल टू फाइट. इट्स इफ वी बिलीव इन आवरसेल्फ, लाइक वी कैन सेल थ्रू इट, थ्रू एनीथिंग इन लाइफ. So, Ruchi, the cancer patients is already going through tough time because of their physical condition due to the side effects of the treatment. And on top of that, gossip and verbal abuse can adversely affect their mental health. What impact can it have on their treatment outcomes and prognosis?
So, Megha, I think, you know, we all must have heard about this famous saying. you know, you get well only if you're healing mentally too and not just physically. And I find it completely, completely true. The treatment of cancer is very, very complicated and severe. Like Aachal and, you know, so a lot of celebrities also, jo ki humne TV pe bhi dekhe hain, there is, you know, so many people we know. Sonali Bindra is one of the most strongest women, you know, we have seen by far. And, you know, this, I guess, it's completely drains a person's energy. हम सिर्फ बोल सकते हैं, हम महसूस नहीं कर सकते वो चीज. एंड इफ इन एडिशन टू दैट दे आर गेटिंग मेंटल प्रेशर बिकॉज ऑफ गॉसिप एंड वर्बल अब्यूज, जस्ट इमेजिन. एंड देन इट विल ऑब्वियसली अफेक्ट देयर फिजिकल वेलबींग. एंड दिस इज सो ट्रू. यू नो आई एम ऑल्सो अ फिटनेस इंस्ट्रक्टर एंड आई कैन वेरी वेल रिलेट विद दिस दैट एक इंसान के लिए फिजिकली, इमोशनली और मेंटली फिट रहना कितना जरूरी है. लाइक आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड कि अगर आप दो बातें उनको प्यार की नहीं बोल सकते ना, तो एटलीस्ट उनको प्लीज नीचे मत गिराइए. उनको कुछ ऐसा मत बोलिए कि जो वो कहते हैं ना, उस स्टेज पे आने से पहले ही अपनी जो एक विल पावर है उसको पहले ही लूज कर दें.
एवरीवन हियरिंग टू दिस नीड्स टू नो दैट we need to give only love and care to patients around us. We have to be very, very sensitive before we talk. Knowingly, unknowingly, we should not do things that can hurt them, because they don't need sympathy. They don't need any kind of extra special behavior. Just be normal to them. Treat them as any other individual and they'll shine. They'll come through it. They'll sail through it. Only if you provide the love and support that they need.
I think they're already sunshine.
That's true. Actually, we have to stop believing on gossips, mega big time, because as I already mentioned, lots of cancer patients are, or now not, they are not anymore patients, survivors or winners. I would say survivor is also a good way to address any cancer fighter, because they fight really hard to win this battle, I believe. I fight to live this life once again, really, really hard, right? So we all need to understand कि हम लोग gossips के चक्कर में और जो चीज़ हमें नहीं पता है karmas के चक्कर में, and it will come back what you talk about. Don't you know manifest that. ये जो सारी चीज़ें हैं ना, इसके चक्कर में कहीं ना कहीं we are holding back ourselves, like you very well said, Megha. And Ruchi also said that के हम लोग ना अगर अच्छा नहीं बोल सकते तो बुरा नहीं बोलना चाहिए. But here we need something else also, you know, which bridge family member cannot cover that bridge, neither a doctor. Because when doctor talk, they thought it's a pure business. When family member or friends talk, they thought why they're talking about, even when they don't know even a percent of what I'm going through, one person, right? But when the cancer fighter come forward or a winner come forward and share a journey with that person, that play a very important role in their life. And I have seen many cancer patients by myself, whom are counseling from their starting to the end treatment. Trust me, the kind of testimonial they send, Bibi, I don't know kahan se wo courage aata hai, but I come over the complete treatment very positively and happily. That wonder we can create in this society, that's what needed right now.
That's so very true. Having the right role model can be of great help. Like, even if I talk about my parents, like both my parents are cancer survivors, and my mother had my dad as a role model. She has seen that it's been 15 years that he's fine and has coped with it well. So when she got it, she never had that fear of death initially, which usually comes in any other person. So having the right role model around you can play a huge, huge role in giving you strength and courage. So
and I think on this, huge respect for all of them. Huge.
Thank you, dear.
Definitely, always. So as we conclude, what are the words of wisdom that you would like to share with our viewers? Starting with you, Anjali.
Yes, so I want to say, please live your life and don't think about society. Society comes after us, right? So first thing, we have to live our own life. Like Megha, trust me, I am doing something which is very funny these days. I'm learning bike, I'm doing art things. I am, you know, also doing something, few things, because my funda is simple, bhaiya. When I will die for sure. I can't do anything in that. But why would I leave my moment at this moment? मैं अभी क्यों जीना छोड़ दूँ? तो भाई मैं तो जी रही हूँ पूरा, और मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आप सब लोग भी अच्छे से जिए और हर एक मोमेंट को एम्ब्रेस करें, इंजॉय करें एंड बी इन द मोमेंट एंड कम फॉरवर्ड टू सपोर्ट अदर्स. दे नीड आवर सपोर्ट अ लॉट.
That's so very inspiring. We also give, like, we have this dream board that we distribute to cancer patients and survivors when they meet, where we ask them to write their dreams and put it in front of them. The whole idea is to live life in the current moment, and that's a beautiful message that you've given. Coming to you, Ruchi, what would you like to say to our viewers?
You know, I'm Jen. So the only beautiful message I can give here is that live and let. Please, that's a request to each one of in the society. You know, I would just like to tell everyone that we have enough hatred and sadness in the world. So if you can be the reason behind someone's smile and laughter, why not be that? Trust me, Megha and Achal, I think that is the most and the biggest beautiful gift you can give it to someone. So just keep spreading happiness and positive around you. Just try to understand what the other person is going through. You know what the problem with us is? We are so judgmental towards the society that आपको नहीं पता होता कि वो इंसान किस trauma से गुजर रहा है या actually उसके साथ कोई problem है. एक छोटे से WhatsApp का answer नहीं आया तो हम इतना बड़ा issue बना लेते हैं, उसने मुझे जवाब नहीं दिया. किसी को हमने call किया, उसने phone नहीं उठाया तो हम उस पर लड़ाई कर लेते हैं, मैंने तुझे फोन किया तूने मेरा फोन नहीं उठाया.
फेसबुक लाइक पे भी लड़ाई हो जाती है रुचि जी
आजकल. एग्जैक्टली, यू नो, आई मीन प्लीज, व्हाट यू कैन डू टू हेल्प देम इज दैट ओवरकम दैट, कीप स्माइलिंग एंड कीप अदर्स स्माइलिंग टू. प्लीज, यू नो, लाइफ इज मच मोर देन दिस. लाइफ बहुत बड़ी है, जितना बड़ा हम उसे बनाना चाहें, जितना पॉजिटिव हम उसे बनाना चाहें या जितना ब्राइटर साइड हम देखना चाहें, तो शायद कहते हैं ना, शीशे के सामने खड़े होके आई थिंक हम सभी को रोज ये बोलना चाहिए. यू नो, अगर एक इंसान के आप चेहरे पे एक स्माइल लेकर आ सकते हैं तो मुझे नहीं लगता उससे बड़ा कोई भी दान होगा, जो हम दान की बातें भी करते हैं, या फिर उससे बड़ा कोई भी ऐसा काम होगा या कर्म होगा जो शायद आप किसी के लिए कर सकते हैं या दे सकते हैं. और ऑन दैट नोट, एक छोटा सा सम स्मॉल फोर लाइन वर्ड्स, दैट बीमारी नहीं है, महामारी है. कैंसर दुनिया पर भारी है, लेकिन कैंसर को हराना है, हारना नहीं है, समझना है, घबराना नहीं.
ब्यूटिफुल. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Achal and Ruchi, for this insightful discussion. I'm sure our listeners are going back with changed perspectives. I hope that we get sensitized as a society and ensure to make every cancer patient's journey easier by showering him or her with only love and support. On this note, it's me, Megha Ahuja, signing off for the day. Take care and stay sushat.